This is the 6-inch by 18-inch Bridgeport Heurig model 618 Easy Surf. 3-axis CNC surface grinder with full enclosure.
And, okay, up front, walker chuck control. We'll try that first when we start going. And here's the spindle drive, actually, variable speed, which is nice. Got the dial on there, we can play with that a little bit. Panel, all pretty standard here. Controls on, transformers. Pretty clean in there. Can't really get all the way around, Pete, but you can kind of see the back of the machine here. It's just all the standard cabling, wires, spindle motor, servo motor for Y up here. Z servo. Hydraulics internal, of course. Come back around the other side here. See the rest of the layout? That's the front of the machine. Got one more side over here. If you want to just kind of take a quick peek. Rest of the control and the cards are in on this side. Feedback, linear feedback cables. That's pretty much it. We're wired currently at 220 volts on this one, three-phase. And having said that, we can play around with a couple of things here. Maybe the chuck first. And let's open up. You okay?
Mm-hmm.
Good. Let's open things up. We've already booted, so it's up and running. The chuck, I could just jump right into.
Let me get on the other side of you.
Oh, yeah, go ahead.
There you go.
I'm just going to do the chuck first, maybe. Just go into variable here at 25%. There we go, yeah. And so that's all pretty good. 50% is better. 75 and full. Just jump over to full, and yeah, that's not too bad. That said, we can, am I up here? Let's see what we got here. Power up the hydraulics. We can go into jog mode here. And we've got jog Z. We can do that a little bit. Which is, well, we got table here, but that's just off the hand wheel. Z is right here off of this hand wheel. Or off the button with the feed control. A little bit faster.
I got to be on the other side.
Okay. Yeah, it's hard to do this. I'll try and do it left-handed. Or we go nice and slow. A little bit slower. That's a slow phase. That's good. Same with Y. We can bring Y down a little bit. We can do a little bit faster. Or slow it down. Pretty good there. Table recip, I won't do it manually, it's not worth it. It's easier for me to do it off the control here. So we've got the two axes there, and hang on a second. Oh, that's right, I don't think you can do wheel without hydraulics, I don't think so. I can turn the wheel on now. I got a white piece of tape on there, Pete, I don't know if you can see it at all, but I'll start off around, I think I'm around 1,000 RPM. I'm gonna hit on now. That's running. That's about 2,500, and for what it's worth, that's about 60%. I can dial it up off the drive here, that's 2,500. You can't hear this thing run, so that's 3 grand. 3,600, pull out. And I said, if you want to go back topside at that, I can slow it down when you're up there, but actually the hydraulics a little bit louder than you can't hear the spindle much. I'm gonna bring it down now, you'll see it. Get this thing pretty slow actually, so
it's okay.
Yep, that's good to go. I'm gonna leave it on because I'm gonna throw in a surface program here and we need that running anyhow. So we could do table. Let's do table reset. Let's do that. Let me get out of here. Let me do an event. Let's do that. Do event. 6, table reset. If I remember right, this is good. Yeah, 6 inches to 11 inches. It's a 5-inch reciprocation. And disengage hand wheel. There we go. Can't leave that in there. That'll work. And there it goes. And now with this one, we got the pull control on this. So it has nothing to do with the feed dial. It's all hydraulic. It's one. Here's one way slow down. That's one side. Slow. I'll speed this back up then on this one. Bring that back up. That's cool. And let me here's on the other side now. I'll do. That all works pretty good. Whatever you want to do with it here. So we'll speed that back up. Leave that for our automatic cycle. Let me come back out of that then. Zero that out and enter. And that's good. And I've got a little, I forget, surface program here, a number 8 surface. Again, in the do event mode. Oh, I didn't mention, but this will also work the Y minus plus. It works really good, the hand wheel. It's a nice feature to have. So that moves real slow. And again, I'm going to go into 8 surface. And I've just got a little 1-inch, 2-inch program built in here. And with one spark out recip on there. This is ready to go. I don't know where I left it. It doesn't matter. It'll find itself whenever I hit start, and it'll just go. Yep. And for the sake of the program, I'm jumping a half inch on Z. I'm coming down about 400 thousandths on Y, just so you can see it in the video. It's very pronounced. It's unrealistic, but it works for the video. You see the jump on the wheel there. Now it'll go down about 3 more times, maybe. And that'll be about it, and then it'll park itself. And we can lower feed right now, too, while we're running here. See? I can slow this thing way down. And you see the Z's moving very little now. And I'll speed it back up. You see it take big jumps now, half inch. There's the spindle. You're getting the whole thing, right? So, yeah. -4, I think that might be where I'm headed to. This would be the end of the program. I think I've got a spark out pass coming up here. Yep, this should be spark out here. One recip and home. It's a happy machine.
It's a wrap.
That's it.
Nice job.
It's that simple.
Thank
Spindle
you.
Off. And power.
Runs well. It's a good tool.